Happy New Year!
We should be choosing what we want to keep, not what we want to get rid of. Marie Kondo. With that, I want to share with you things that spark joy, things that I want to bring with me into 2020. I'll be sharing two items in each category, just because 2020. Get it? First up, we have self-care, beauty/skincare. A couple of holy grail items I discovered in 2019 that I will definitely keep using in 2020 were the Innisfree Tangerine Brightening and Pore Refining Sleeping Mask and the Sumi Haigo Setuken Charcoal Bar Soap. I hope I didn't butcher that. The sleeping mask really helped to lighten up hyperpigmentation and brighten up complexion overall. Plus, it smells delicious. Sleeping masks can be a hit or a miss because they can be sticky and very messy, but this one kind of just absorbs into your skin so you won't find any yucky residue all over your pillow the next morning. As for this charcoal soap, I actually heard about it from one of Kim Dao's videos, and it really is a great recommendation for oily or combo type skin. Even though it is a soap, it doesn't leave your skin feeling super dry and tight. Just squeaky clean without the squeak. Moving on to productivity/organization items, I want to give a major shout out to the Passion Planner and the Fortune City app. As I shared in a few previous vlogs, I got this Passion Planner for free from Colombia, but it is a worthwhile investment. If you're tight on the money, the Passion Planner team does provide free PDF printouts of some of its templates, so you can totally jump on that and even make your Passion Planner digital. You've seen the Fortune City app multiple times in various videos as well. And I started using this fun expense tracker really early in 2019. Yes, fun! Seeing the amount of money you shell out isn't always fun, but this app is so beautifully designed and it kind of makes tracking expenses less painful. To continue on with the tech, next up we have software/apps. Mendeley and PDF Expert are my must-have recommendations for students out there. Mendeley is a free reference manager, and having the browser extension and built-in Microsoft Word tool pack is so helpful when it comes down to writing papers, since you always should be citing and giving due credit. You don't have to look up different types of citation styles each time because this reference manager automatically helps you convert between them for you. Before getting to writing the paper, you often have to read up on research. I featured PDF Expert on What's on My iPad video recently, and it really is a godsend in terms of studying and annotating readings. It has tons of tools for free. Now that we have all the busy bee stuff out of the way, let's talk entertainment. Mad PD shows and Korean Englishmen on YouTube were by far my favorite productions to turn to in 2019 for some respite. Mad PD shows aren't very much of a discovery because I've been a fan of New Journey to the West for a very long time, and I have also watched quite a few of his old shows in the past. However, after ditching Running Man, finding I Live Alone and Omniscient Interviewing View to be increasingly boring, Mad PD really helped to give me a dose of laughter when I needed it. New Journey to the West, Season 7, Kong's Kitchen, Season 2 and 3, Youth Over Flowers, and etc. were the shows. My new favorite YouTubers are Josh and Ollie from Korean Englishman/Jolly. You may or may not remember that I've done a video where I shared my top 10 YouTubers before. Unfortunately, I stopped watching quite a lot of those YouTubers, including Bubs. So in 2019, I spent quite a bit of time not really consuming any YouTube content because I didn't really have any YouTubers that produced the type of content that I found to be interesting. Then I came across Korean Englishman. Josh and Ollie are really great, and their mission of spreading Korean culture is super admirable. Plus, I'm always rooting for Ollie on his quest to master Korean. Fighting! Speaking of YouTubers, I'm a YouTuber myself, so I want to share two video editing tools that I will definitely continue using in 2020. They are Vello, that's V-L-L-O, and InShot. I really like Vello to edit my videos in general because you can add GIFs and whatnot, and they have tons of free captions, stickers, and etc. When I want cuter fonts and more flexibility with my text inserts, including animations, I turn to InShot. So I basically go back and forth between these apps and then kind of compile everything on iMovie. And that's pretty much it for the things that worked well for me in 2019 that I guess sparked joy, and I want to bring them with me into 2020. What things will spark joy for you in 2020? I challenge you to think of the things that you want to keep from 2019 that will continue to spark joy for you in 2020. Thank you so much for watching. And I want to remind you to subscribe if you haven't already. hit the bell button for notifications, and of course, thumbs up on this video if you did like it, and I always want you to comment down below. Seriously, let me know what worked well for you in 2019 that you want to keep in 2020. Happy New Year!